Hey, Eric Eltsholtz at West here. I wanted to talk to you about something that you can be doing on a daily basis. Now, mostly this applies to relationship-driven realtors, but something very interesting happened mid-March of 2019, and that something was Facebook and Instagram going down for about a 24-hour period. I don't know if that freaked you out, but I know a lot of people that put a lot of trust in how many friends they have in their sphere in Facebook. So, I like to treat all social media channels as a digital farm. And that's one thing that you've worked hard. You've done posting, you've sent friend requests, you've accepted friend requests. So these are people that have affiliated and associated themselves with you, and they're valuable to you. That's probably your number one asset is people in the real estate industry. So why do we tend to take these people that are a valuable asset and leave them in a box or a cup or a bucket that we don't control? So, I've been talking for years about collecting people out of your social media channels and making sure and put them into your CRM so that you can access them and integrate and engage these people, not only in the social media platform, but outside of that in other ways. So let's go take a look at something that I think you could do very easily every day. And let's put this in perspective. Here's what it is. It's that I think you should engage with at least three people in your social media environment every day. While you're doing that, I think you could collect those people out of social media and place them into your CRM. Think about that. If you just connected with three people every day, at the end of the month, you would have had some personal engagement with 90 of your social media peers, your sphere of influence, your prospects, your prospect pool, whatever you want to call it. But that's huge. Don't you agree with that? So here's a really quick way to do that. So let's go take a look. And what I would do is I'd basically pull up and make it like every morning you wake up, you have your cup of coffee, you sit down, and you log into your Facebook page. Let's go back to the screen and take a look at what I would do from there. And start harvesting your friends from your social media environments and collect those people and actually put them into your database. So let's go check this out. Head on over to a post that you've recently done, right? And here's how you're going to collect people. Obviously, your number one group of friends that you need to pay attention to are the people that are engaging with you. So what's engagement? That's anybody that's liked, commented, or shared one of your posts. So let's go after those people first. So here's what you can do. I'll go down to a post here. Here we go. Let's look at a couple things. So one, you can go to the people that are liking your posts and you can click this little box. And what'll happen is you'll actually have a modal window that'll pop open right here. So the first thing you should be looking for is one, if your posts are being shared, you should be able to add these people in as potential friends to yourself, right? So you can click and add a friend button, and all of a sudden that person will get an invite from you. The other thing that you can do is right while you're in here, you can interact with these people, basically reciprocate their engagement, because right here you could message them. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to go collect this person's information. Okay, I can click on their name, or I'm just going to do this open in a new tab and check it out. It's going to take me over to Mr. Tucker's page. And I'm going to do a couple things. I'm going to click over to his About section, and I'm going to go look to see if I've got his contact information. And in this case, I don't. So here's an individual that I want to make sure I have in my database. So I'm going to copy his name, right? And I'm going to go over to my database here, and I'm going to add a new contact in. Okay. So I'm going to paste that information in there. Right, and there we go. I've got it cleaned up, and I know what company he's with right there. And okay, so I don't have his email or his phone number. What I do have, though, check this out. I've also got his profile, so I'm going to copy that, and I'm going to put that into my database here, correct? So I'm going to pop this in. That's his Facebook profile, right? And now I can click save. Or the other thing I can do is right while I'm here, I can engage with him. So here we go. I'm going to pop open a message, and I'm going to say, hey, thanks for the like. Let's see. I notice I don't have your personal email. Can you send it to me? Mark, and bang, I can zip that off. So many times I'll actually be doing a demo like this, and you'll actually see someone respond immediately and give you their email. So that's one way that you can both engage with someone and collect their content at the same time. This is about a 90% of the time thing. If they're your friend, they consider you a friend, and they will actually give you their email with that contact. Again, on a pretty regular basis, you'll find that a lot of these people will have this information in their database already. So let's go look at a different post, right? So here's a different one. I can pop open this modal window, and I can go into someone, and I can say, okay, so who in here do I not have their contact information? And you can go grab that information at that point. So this is just a great way to ask for additional contact information, and many times people will give you that information. So here I'm going to go check out this individual, and we'll go look at them. And get the same thing. There we go, right? I'm going to go check out his about information. So look at this. I've got an email address, and I've got a phone number. So again, I can come over here with this phone number. I can copy that down. I can go over to my database. I can add a new person in here. Right. And I can pop a phone number in there. Right, it's a mobile phone number, and I copy it in there. There we go. I can go in here and do the same thing. Right, while I'm on here, I can message them and say, so there you go, right? Hey, I want to send you something. And send, off you go. And at that point, again, it's about a 90% rate that someone will actually give you their email back instantaneously.
So what do you think? That was pretty easy, right? Cup of coffee, engage with three of your contacts or prospects, and at the end of the month, you've connected with 90 people in a unique fashion, whether that was via email, whether it was via text, whether it was via social media message, or literally a phone call. Doesn't matter. Pick one way to engage with them, but that's a simple way. And think about this. At the end of the day, at the end of the month, you've also captured and connected with 90 people that you've taken out of your social media platform and you've put into your CRM where you actually control the data. I think that's great. Listen, have a great day. This is Eric Eltzholtz at West. Don't forget to visit us at themoderndayagent.com for more information, tips, blog posts, and technology package platform reviews and updates. Talk to you later. Bye.